Hello everyone. In this session, we will learn about microscale volumetric analysis. Before that, let us have a look at the conventional volumetric analysis and the need to shift to microscale method. Volumetric analysis is the estimation of a chemical species by measurement of volume. It is done by the process of titration. By titration, it is possible to find out the unknown concentration of a known reactant. The understanding of following terms is important to understand volumetric analysis. Analyte, solution of unknown concentration whose concentration is to be estimated. Titrant, a reagent of known concentration used in the estimation of analyte. Endpoint, the point at which the reaction between analyte and titrant is complete. Indicator, substances like phenolphthalein, methyl orange, etc., which give a characteristic color change at the endpoint. Based on the type of chemical reaction involved, titrometric analysis can be classified into acid base, oxidation reduction, precipitation, and complex formation titrations. Now, let us gain an understanding of conventional versus microscale method by taking the example of estimation of sodium hydroxide using standardized hydrochloric acid, which is an acid-based titration. In conventional method, we pipette out 20 ml of our analyte, sodium hydroxide, into a conical flask. This is followed by the addition of methyl orange indicator, which gives a golden yellow color in sodium hydroxide solution. This is titrated against titrant, which is standardized hydrochloric acid taken in the burette, and at the end point of titration, there is a color change from golden yellow to orange red. Performing a single titration in this method requires approximately 20 ml of both analyte and titrant. Consider a lab of students, say 40. Based on this calculation, we can see that a huge amount of chemical waste would be generated at the end of each lab. Disposal of this waste from lab is often a big problem, and this has now paved way for microscale analysis. Microscale chemistry is an analytical method working with small quantities of chemical substances. When we do estimation of NaOH using hydrochloric acid by microscale method, both the analyte and titrant are taken in burettes. 10 ml of sodium hydroxide solution is measured using a burette and transferred into a conical flask. Methyl orange indicator is added into the solution to get a golden yellow color. It is titrated against the standardized hydrochloric acid taken in second burette to get orange-red color at the end point. The molarity of NaOH is calculated as in conventional method, say M1. 1 ml of NaOH is added to the titrated solution in the conical flask. The color of solution changes back to golden yellow. It is again titrated against the HCl solution from the same burette. With this new volume of the solution, the molarity of NaOH, M2, is calculated. The process is repeated 3 more times to get molarities M3, M4 and M5. Thus, forgetting 5 molarity values, a total of around 14 ml solution is used and statistical average is taken. Molarity value can also be calculated using graphical method. A graph is plotted between the volume of analyte and titrant. The molarity equation is rearranged into the form of equation of a straight line, and using this, the molarity of NaOH is calculated using graphical method. Thus, we can see that to carry out 5 titrations using conventional method, we require about 100 ml solutions of both. Whereas, to carry out the same number of titrations using microscale method, we require only 14 ml of both solutions. Thus, there is clearly a drastic decrease in the amount of chemicals used. Apart from this, microscale analysis has few other advantages. They are: no use of pipette. Conventional method requires the use of pipette. Sometimes the solution sucked by a pipette may be corrosive or toxic or strong enough to damage parts of mouth. In this method, no solution is sucked by mouth and hence the method is safe. Indicator is added only once, unlike conventional method which requires the addition of indicator for every single titration. Another advantage is that microscale method requires less time. The results obtained by this method are more accurate since statistical averaging is used. Thus, we can say that microscale volumetric analysis is more advantageous than conventional one. 10 microscale titrations requires lesser amount of chemicals than one conventional method. It is also more safe to the environment as only fewer amount of chemicals is being disposed into the environment. Microscale volumetric analysis is a very economical method. Hope you all have understood microscale volumetric analysis. Thank you.